Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. Yesterday, we talked about hiding columns. So let's say that I hide several columns, format column hide, and now I need to unhide those columns. Usually what we do is we select the column to the left and the column to the right of the two columns and use format column unhide. But what if one of the columns you've hidden is column A? There's no way to select the column to the left of it. So let me select a few columns here, format column hide. Now, if I select column E and do format column unhide, it's not going to know what I'm talking about. It's going to think that I just want to unhide column E. The trick is to actually click on the E and drag over until you're above the row numbers, and you'll see the little tooltip there says that I've selected five columns. Now, if I do format column unhide, I'm able to unhide that data. Let me hide some columns again. And here's a fantastic trick, but it only works if you have one obscure setting on the computer. Let's say that I need to see some of the data that's in a hidden column, but I don't actually want to unhide the column. If I go to a blank cell, type an equal sign, and then pretend that I'm using the Lotus arrow key method of creating a formula. So in other words, I'm going to go point to a cell by hitting the left arrow. As soon as I do that, Excel unhides all of the hidden columns, and I'm able to see what's going on. Now, I've been using this trick for years and years and years, and when I put it in the book, people said, whoa, wait a second, that doesn't work for me. Turns out that you have to go to Tools, Options, and on the Transition tab, choose Transition Navigation Keys. Now, of course, if you're using all the Excel navigation keys, this will cause more problems than it's worth, but give it a try if you're usually using hidden columns. Great way to be able to see the data without unhiding the columns. Hey, thanks for stopping by. We'll see you tomorrow for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.